If you would please remain standing for the presentation of the colors by our National Junior Honors, or National Guard. You all please remain standing while one of our seniors, Arandi, sings our national anthem.
Stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watched were so gallantly streaming. And the rocket's red glare, the bombs bursting, that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the land of the
Would please remain standing for the Pledge of Allegiance. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Thank you. You may be seated. How about another round of applause for NJROTC and a Randy for singing that national anthem? Woo! At this time, I'd like to introduce Carl Herman and Sandra Lean and the Apache Junction High School Band and Orchestra as they play Star Wars Through the Years by John Williams, arranged by Stephen Bulla. Thank you to our band and to our orchestra, Mr. Herman and Ms. Lean. At this time, I'd like to introduce our senior class president, Megan Gossman.
Good evening, everyone, and welcome to the Apache Junction High School Class of 2023 graduation. My name is Megan Gossman, and I am so pleased to be introducing this ceremony tonight because I am standing in front of the people whom I grew up with. I've spent the past 4 years as class president, and it has been amazing to see how everyone has changed. We went through our own phases and styles that were sometimes questionable, and after tonight, we're going to be asked the daunting question: what are your plans after graduation? I can already hear the crickets. Anyways, it's not easy to answer this question, guys. This is our life that we're deciding. I know what I'm doing, probably taking pictures with my family and then leaving, but after that, I'm not sure. Everyone here tonight, thank you for getting us across this stage. Some of us probably never thought we would make it this far. I sure didn't think I would be standing in front here giving the welcoming speech at my own graduation, but here I am. I hope that your lives are filled with surprises and excitement. And I hope it gets hard and then easier, because that is what makes us who we are, and that is what gets us wherever we might end up. We will make mistakes, everyone has. I did. I wrote the speech at 1 a.m. last night. But when you make mistakes, learn to work through them and move on, just like we're moving on to the next stage in our life right now. So whether you're headed off to college, the military, a job, taking a long-needed break, or just going with the flow, do it with pride and remember that you will forever be a prospector. I would like to add one more thing before handing over the stage. I have had one principal all 4 years of high school. And to most of you, that probably sounds pretty normal, but that hasn't always been the case at AJHS. Although you will be leaving us, thank you, Dr. Lineberry, or as I like to call him, C. Dizzle, for giving us a sense of normalcy and strength. My heart is sad for the underclassmen who will no longer get to experience Dr. Lineberry and Heather Wallace here at AJ. I won't go on thanking everyone I possibly know, but
I will thank you for listening to me ramble on. To some of you, hello and goodbye. Class of 2023,
we did it.
Thank you, Megan. Good evening, students, parents, colleagues, and guests, Prospector Nation. I'm Dr. Chris Lineberry, your Apache Junction High School principal, and I want to welcome you this evening as we honor the AJHS class of 2023. I'd like to begin the evening by introducing a few special guests who join us on the stage. Please hold your applause till the end, and all guests have been introduced. Apache Junction Unified School Superintendent, Dr. Robert Papalardo, AJUSD's Governing Board President, Ms. Dina Kimball, Governing Board Vice President, Mr. Gil Concio, and Governing Board members, Mr. Bobby Bowders, Ms. Cammie Garcia, and Ms. Gail Ross. I'd like to introduce Assistant Principals, Dr. Tanya Knight and Hans Raymond, our Mayor, Chip Wilson, and our City Manager, Brian Powell, and as well as Commander Johnny John from the Apache Junction Police Department. Those who have helped behind the scenes tonight to make this possible, I'd also like to AHS staff and teachers. Last but not least, I'd like to acknowledge and thank all of you parents, grandparents, friends, and family who have tirelessly supported these seniors and played such an important role in their success. It's a privilege, and I'm honored to be part of this very special ceremony, and we're here to recognize and honor the students of Apache Junction High School. Please welcome this year's salutatorium, Sage Miguel Gaspar.
evening to all of my fellow graduates, relatives, friends, and community members who came to show your support tonight. I am so glad that you are here. Before I begin my remarks, I would like to extend a few thank yous to people in the audience. First, I would like to thank my grandparents, who are over on the side, for bringing my family to America and allowing us to have a better life. My parents for supporting me throughout my educational career. My little brother for being my little brother. my aunts and uncles for always being supportive, and my extended family. Thank you to the Canale family, all of my present, past, and future educators, and all other educators in the district for the sacrifices that you have made to ensure that we have the opportunities to thrive. And thank you to my close friends for always being such a gracious support system. I would also like to extend a round of applause to all the parents and guardians of my fellow graduates, as this journey would not have been possible without your never-ending support. You deserve recognition tonight as well. So once again, my name is Sage Miguel Gaspar, and I am so incredibly grateful to be speaking in front of you tonight. Now, what is success? I know this question may be ironic coming from me, as on paper, my current position may be a standard of success in today's society for kids our age. After all, throughout the educational endeavor, the numbers on standardized tests, GPAs, and class rank have always been repeatedly emphasized as the most crucial part of our being. I'm not saying that I'm not grateful for the position that I am in right now, because I most definitely am incredibly gracious for this opportunity. After all, I am a first-generation student, and I am the first in my family to pursue a college education. So this achievement feels incredibly momentous for me, and I am so grateful to all of my scholarship foundations for paying for my education. I am incredibly grateful for that. however, I don't believe comparing yourself to the benchmark should dictate your achievements. Something that I believe is special about all of us is the individual. And I don't mean the color bar you earned on your test, but the circumstances in which you survived. All of us have gone on different journeys to arrive at the same position. Some of us have lost loved ones, while others have become parents and gained new ones. Some of us have endured mental health struggles, and some of us have had a pleasant sail down this river of life. Whatever the journey, we all arrived here. For the past 13 years, we all worked hard through life's obstacles to ensure we ended up here and walk the stage. Education is a pillar of life that can never be taken away from you. Even if it feels like you've hit the lowest part in your life, where you have lost everything, you will always still have your education. And this, my friends, is a huge stepping stone in your route to success and fulfillment in life. If no one else has told you yet, I am so incredibly proud of you and all of our class for attaining this achievement. Now, do you remember being asked, what do you want to be when you grow up as a kindergartner? You may have answered something like police officer, doctor, or even astronaut. What about in middle school or the beginning of your senior year? As the years passed, the same question seemed to recede in its playful nature, and every year I disliked that question more and more. I'm sure some of you had the same experience as you realized that every year you came closer to this, graduation, where the deadlines have come and gone, when you, sitting in your chair, should have your life figured out. College applications ask the same question. What is your declared major? If you're going straight into the workforce of the military, they ask, what are your expectations for growth within this company or branch? Which are just two fancy ways of phrasing that same question. I know at this moment, this question may seem incredibly daunting to you, as we are all just teenagers and this could be a life-changing decision. However, I urge you to take this question to a deeper level. We've all heard stories of those who have earned millions of materialistic gains for their career but are not satisfied with their life. And I don't know about you, but I don't want to live like that. Think to yourself, what are your passions? Whatever it is, hold it near and dear to your heart, even if it seems a bit rebellious. In fact, I encourage you to change your mind a few times. Keep searching until you find what makes you happy and fulfilled, and continue creating that magic for yourself, no matter how silly it may seem. Your success is whatever you make of it. From this point on, we are all considered young adults, whether we like it or not. In life, there will always be setbacks, regardless of how type A your personality is. It is important to realize that mistakes will be made, and they will not always be your fault. Sometimes they are, but try not to beat yourself up too hard. Don't be afraid to accept help from others, and don't be shy to lend a helping hand to those who need it. Once you realize that not every circumstance is in your control, but the result you make of every circumstance is, You will learn to begin, you will begin to learn that your success is made of a series of trials and errors compiled together in hopes that you will overcome them. I wish you all luck on your future endeavors in life and wish you the most happiness and fulfillment on your journeys. To all of my friends who have not graduated yet or those in the crowd, I hope you take my message to heart and hopefully leave wondering your why in life. Don't stop searching until you feel in your heart that you have reached the highest peak of happiness that you can. Not until then will you be successful. If you never make the move to start looking for your success story, you will never make it, and life moves way too fast to live a mundane life. There is no better time to start than now. Thank you again for your time, and congratulations to the class of 2023.
Thank you. Fantastic job, Sage. Thank you. Now I would like to introduce our valedictorian, Kendall Powell.
Wow, class of 2023, woo! It has been such a wild past 4 years. We've had our ups and downs, and we have had to overcome a lot as the class of 2023. I mean, we started freshman year not knowing where a single classroom was, or even where the buildings were, and now we have the entire campus memorized from North Gym to student parking lot. At the start of our sophomore year, we were stuck at home, struggling with Zoom links, staying awake, and being lonely. By the end of the year, we were back in person, but we learned to never take each other for granted. As juniors, we overcame false prejudices about AJHS and proved that we are just as smart and intelligent as students at surrounding schools by receiving a B grade on our state testing scores. As seniors, we're now figuring out our next steps and getting ready to take off in life. And if the past 4 years have showed us anything, it's that we can take on any challenge that life throws our way. We've had to overcome and adapt quite a bit these past 4 years, but I think we've managed to have some really amazing times together. Homecoming and prom are always two standouts regarding memorable moments in high school. Getting to dress up in our favorite dresses and suits always made us feel so cool. Getting to go out to dinner before the dances allowed us to feel grown up and mature. And going to the dance itself was always freeing and fun with the dim lights and loud music. Things can get pretty wild at AJHS dances. I can't tell you the number of times when dance circles would form, and I would look in the middle of the circle, and someone would be aggressively flopping around on the floor trying to do the worm. And I mean, we've had some other pretty memorable experiences as well. For example, at the prom this year, we actually got to witness a dance battle between our school truancy officer, Officer Wright, and our beloved student council and PE teacher, Coach McKee. It was actually a pretty decent and legit dance battle. Who knew two middle-aged men would be so gifted at dancing? At one point, McKee was on the floor spinning around in a circle doing a dance move called the windmill. It was such a great moment watching one of our school officers and one of our teachers have so much fun while the student body cheered them on. Homecoming and prom were experiences that we only got to live while in high school, so I hope you all took the opportunity to go and do it. I would also like to take this time to acknowledge our Prospector Athletics. This was a great year for our mighty Prospector football team, led by seniors Gavin Lamangelo, Garrett Garcia, Maxwell Jada, Tavon Franco, and Dane Fiddler. Our football team went 7-3 in the regular season and made it to round one of the state playoffs. This was also a great accomplishment. This was a great accomplishment for the team that really helped AJHS to shine. Also in the fall was cheerleading, swim, golf, cross country, and band. In the winter, we had basketball, soccer, and wrestling. And finally, in the spring, we had softball, baseball, track, and tennis. From track, senior Mason Cooksey went to state for shot put. And girls tennis, led by seniors Megan Gossman, Bailey Furrow, Riza Garcia, Andrea Garcia, and myself, had an exceptional season this year, going 10-3 in the regular team matches. Seniors Megan and Bailey also made it to the first round of state playoffs for doubles tennis. I wish I could include all the students who made all region, all state, got any cool awards, or are continuing to play their sport through college. But unfortunately, my time is limited, and I'm sure it's posted somewhere on social media. Either way, huge congrats to all the prospector athletes out there who worked hard over the past 4 years. You've brought AJ pride, tradition, and respect. To start the close of my speech, I would just like to say that you guys are the absolute best. I have gotten to know many of you personally and deeply, not just over the past 4 years, but the past 13, since the Peralta Trail, Desert Vista, Smez, and Four Peaks days. Personally, I went to Peralta Trail, and as I look around, I can see the faces of many peers that I've known since kindergarten, and I recognize even more peers that I've known since seventh grade in Cactus Canyon. I hope you all take a moment to look around and take in the people sitting around you, because we have grown up together, and now we are saying goodbye one last time. But, I mean, we really aren't saying goodbye to each other, because I'm sure we'll still see each other in the store, or at the lake, or on social media somewhere. But right now, we are saying goodbye to the life we've lived up to this point in the Apache Junction School District. From here on out, we get to take everything we have learned and observed and implement it into our daily lives in the real world. We now get to take everything that has been taught to us in the past and use it in our future. And I'm so excited to see what we all do. Of course, none of this would be possible without the administration, staff, teachers, janitors, maintenance crew, and bus drivers that keep the whole production moving along. I would like to give a special shout out to Dr. Lyne Berry, who has worked so diligently these past 4 years to help our students progress. It's been great working with you, Dr. Lineberry, and thanks again for everything. I would also like to shout out all of the amazing teachers here at AJHS. You are the true heroes of tonight, and your impact cannot be undervalued. None of this would be possible without you and your dedication to the students of AJHS. Once again, the class of 2023 from Apache Junction High School is amazing. We might not know what the future holds, but I am certain that it is bright for every student sitting on the field right now. I can't believe I'm here, and I'm so grateful for it. And before I leave, do you guys want to be in my Be Real? Yeah! Get it, guys? Are you out yet? Smile! All right, guys, I love ya. I'll see you around. Go Prospectors!
That's why she's president and valedictorian. Next up, I'd like to introduce our mayor, Mr. Chip Wilson, who has a couple awards for our graduates.
Well, I'm not going to be out there yelling like that. Good evening, everyone, and howdy. Before I congratulate the newest class graduates from Apache Junction High School, I want to remind you of people that came before you. Did you know we see Apache Junction High School alumni everywhere? They are business leaders, community leaders, and respectful people of our community. Did you also know the Parks and Rec Director for the graduating class of 1991, not 61, excuse me. There are people in the police department, fire department, who work for business throughout the city. They not only came back to Apache Junction, but are now leaders in our community. They love Apache Junction just like we all do. So I challenge you to remember your community needs. You, maybe you can run a business, raise your family in Apache Junction. Maybe you can even take over for me and help me with my misspelled words here. So wish you all well and congratulate you on the great achievements, and I look forward to seeing you in and around the community again. And on behalf of the City of Apache Junction, congratulations to the class of 2023. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. Appreciate it. Thank you very much.
All right, guys, we're almost there. So I'd like to take a few moments to say a couple things about this class. I love Apache Junction High School, and I love each and every one of you. As you all know, I have two younger children, Ben and Maddie, and at my last school, they would come to events with me, just like they do here. And one day, this kid walks up to my son, Ben, and says, "I don't like our principal. He has too many rules." My son says, "Really? Do you know who I am?" And the kid says, "No." And he says, "Well, I'm the principal's son." And the kid looks at him and says, "Well, do you know who I am?" And Ben said, "No." And the kid said, "Good," and ran away as fast as he could. We all have people who believe in us. And I can only imagine for the people here sitting in front of me how those people out there feel right now. And as you get ready to walk across this stage, know that you carry their love and support with you just as you have the past 13 years in school. Parents, you've exhibited incredible grace, patience, and grit the last 4 years. And on behalf of the faculty, staff, and the students, I say thank you. Thank you. I thank you for your support this school year and for all you've done to help your children in our school. Graduates, as I thought about what to say tonight, I thought about what I had heard at my graduations, and I couldn't remember any of it. So the pressure's off because you probably won't remember this anyway. But when deciding what to say, I decided to focus on something that I've learned over my years here on the planet. And it's very simple. Ego is the enemy. My favorite TV show is Ted Lasso. And if you haven't seen it, I highly recommend it. There's a scene where Ted, who's the main character, is challenged to a game of darts by a guy who's arrogant and ego-driven. The guy's just a jerk. Ted hits the bullseye, and the first time, and he says, looks at the guy and says, "You know, guys have underestimated me my entire life. And for years, I never understood why. It used to really bother me. But then one day, I was driving my little boy to school, and I saw this quote from Walt Whitman painted on the wall that said, 'Be curious, not judgmental.' I like that." So I get back in my car and I'm driving to work and all of a sudden it hits me. All them fellas who used to belittle me, not a single one of them was curious. They thought they had everything figured out, so they judged everything and everyone. And I realized that their underestimating me had nothing to do with me. Because if they were curious, they would have asked questions. Like, "Ted, have you ever played darts before?" And I would have answered, "Yes, sir," every Saturday with my dad from 10 years old until he died when I was 16. And he threw another perfect bullseye. The point is, Ted was speaking of ego, an unhealthy belief on our own importance. Arrogance, self-centered ambition, ego convinces us that we've attained a level of knowledge that says that we don't need to learn and that we are comfortable. I don't say this to you from a place of judgment at all. I say this to you from a place of experience. Asking for help is okay. As you climb the ladder of success, and you've all already started that tonight, there'll be cheap shots. You won't get credit for work you've done. People will doubt you, both to your face and behind your back. And when they do, smile. Take it. Work harder. But above all else, don't let it distract you from what has to be done. Remember, everybody is a teacher. Sometimes we learn what to do. Sometimes we learn what not to do. Sometimes we learn, Sometimes we learn what to do. Sometimes we learn what not to do, but we can always learn from others. I want to encourage you to be lifelong learners. There's a great quote by a physicist named John Wheeler that says, "As the island of knowledge grows, so does the shoreline of ignorance." Never stop learning. Ego tells you, "I've got this. I don't have to study. I already know." Ego says, "Don't be curious." Ego dulls the pickaxe, the tool we need to mine our human potential. Our ability to learn, to grow, and to build relationships is all dulled by ego. Stay humble. Stay honest and stay courageous. The last 4 years have been hard and at times brutal. When I first started here, you guys were freshmen and my hair and my beard were black. They aren't anymore. As my mother would say, I look more distinguished. However, the past 4 years have also helped us to grow stronger, more together, and more determined. Our graduation rate from the state is 10 points higher than it was last year. and 92% of the students who started this school year as seniors are going to walk across this stage tonight. That's the highest rate in over a decade. We have won on the field, we have won on the court, we have won on the stage, and we have won in the classroom. And I am most proud of the relationships that I've been able to build over the last 4 years. You, the students and staff, I am so proud of you for carrying our school from 0.3 of a point from a D to coming out of COVID as a B for the first time in over 10 years. In fact, only 67 schools in the entire state grew more than you did last year. You, the
student, staff, and parents and community of Apache Junction did that, and nobody can ever take that away from you.
Remember, a prospector is a person who chips away at the rock and the shale, though exhausted, continues to swing the pickaxe to get to the precious elements underneath. Mountains over here behind us, those cradle the legends of those who at one time swung a pickaxe searching for the value within. As prospectors, I want to challenge each of you to do that in your lives. If you get knocked down, get up. Swing the pickaxe of grit, curiosity, loyalty, self-discovery, and hard work with all of your power. Swing at the challenges before you and continue to mine your human potential. I am proud of you. We are proud of you, and you should be proud of you. Be courageous, be bold, be humble, and be prospectors. Prospectors, now it's time. So if you would please save your applause until all graduates have been recognized. Graduates on the first row, please rise.
Damon Baum.
Yeah, yeah, brother.
Liliana Alvarez Flores.
Hunter Beamer.
Riley Anderson.
Matthew Bisa.
Jesus Donovan Apodaca McFerrin.
Kayla Bolin.
Atsiri Armijo Ibarra.
Landon Bongo.
Bree Ariana Ayers.
Gabriella Boyd.
Giselle Ayon Beltran.
Olive Branscombe.
Zoe Barker.
Hayden Brossman.
Evelyn Kayleen Barraza Cruz de los Santos.
Lily Buckner.
Autumn Bartlett.
Nevea Valentina Cervantes.
Skylar Burnham.
Major Teetle.
Nicholas Butterfield.
Devin Clark.
Katana Cricket Cameron.
Candolin Annalie Cobb.
Rowan Canali.
Hannah Compton.
Sherlyn Cardenas Armenta.
Yamileth Contreras León.
Irandi Vanessa Carlos Iron.
Mason Cooksey.
Brooke Carlson.
Rosa Isela Corona Garcia.
Juliana Lisbeth Carrillo.
Connor Cortez.
Lexi Carrillo.
Jonah Costley.
Keegan Cox.
Haley Savannah Dorr.
Jason Cross.
I'm keeping this one.
Naquay Dorsey.
Catherine Elizabeth Davis.
Caitlin Drury.
Simon Deal.
Richard Lee Duchesne.
Kylie Anne Marie DePriest.
Elijah Marcel Jr. Edwards.
Gilberto Diaz.
Dominic Elizondo.
Yeah. Peyton Dillon.
Emily England.
Drea Dixon.
Carter Urshan.
Serena Dodge.
Jose Eduardo Espinosa Torres.
Giselle Alejandra Dominguez.
Esmeralda Montserrat Espinosa Torres.
Sebastian Esparza.
Adrian Romeo Felix.
Sophia Fitzpatrick.
Angel Rafael Sandoval.
Brian Edwin Flores Miramontes.
Gerard Usa Jr.
Teresa Forte.
Garrett Garcia.
Kylie Fox.
Raisa Alejandra Garcia.
Natalie Francois.
James Geary.
Tavon Stephen Franco.
Kai Gilletti.
Carson Ryder Frisch.
Jacob Glazner.
Bailey March Farrow.
Kyle Gombos.
Kylie Marie Gallegos.
Adrian Gonzalez Jr.
Andrea May Garcia.
Elizabeth Hera.
Michael Joseph Gossman Jr.
Brooke Henshaw.
Megan Elizabeth Gossman.
Mackenzie Lynn Bulls Herman.
Juliana Grabowski.
Alexis Hernandez Garcia.
Good job, Teresa.
Dia Granillo.
Brenda Carolina Hernandez.
Drain Marie Drake.
Mackenzie Hill.
Not my niece.
Carson Green.
Tajaya Hooks.
Chance Grimes.
Trent Howard.
Nathan James Gronenberg.
Diana Huerta.
Javier Guillen.
Andrew Knox.
Kayla Lorraine Guash.
Terry Lape.
Cody Humphreys.
Evan Larned.
Carlos Ariel Juarez Reyes, El Rey.
Colson Latier.
Pedro Ibanez.
Giovanna Levo.
Tyler Iglinski.
Glo Mangelo.
Max Jada.
Reagan Longacre.
Carla Mazzoni James.
Gabriel Lucas.
Austin Johnson.
Gianni Frank Angelo Mahon.
Michael David Johnson.
Alexis Manduhano.
Keegan Keys.
Andrew Miranda.
Joshua Wyman.
Angel Miranda.
Abby Joy.
Miranda Garcia.
Fabrice Martin.
Liliana Mitchke.
Susana Francisco Martinez.
Priscilla Molinar.
Obed Martinez.
Isaias Anthony Montes.
Cameron McFadden.
Alexis J. Morales.
Justin McIntosh. Kaylee
McWilliams.
Ryan Morris.
Sage Miguel Gaspar.
Marlo Pacheco.
Julia Cecilia Mills Arellano.
Gabriela Paez.
Vincent Neal.
Adriel Palencia.
Sophia Marie Nelson.
Dominic Lucas Gonzalez.
Riley Newman.
Noel Parker.
Madeline Claire Nicola.
Alex Vicente Pascual Paz.
Isaac Nitzo.
Omar Perez Franco.
Beatrice.
Jeremiah Petilla.
Evelyn Olivas Cifuentes.
Laura Alyssa Parrard Sarudi.
Tatiana Lisette Horta.
Reagan Robinson.
Francisco
Cortez Osuna.
Anthony Rodriguez.
Hannah O'Toole.
Jose Luis Rodriguez de Santiago.
Kaya Plummen.
Natalie Roerig.
Kendall Ann Powell.
Sergio Romero Villegas.
Connor Raider. Celeste Ramirez Ariola.
Madeline Rossman.
Jocelyn Ramirez Rosas.
Triton Cole Ellis Ryan.
Gabriel Reitzma Paredes.
Arilene Salas Para.
Brianna Desiree Reyes.
Kevin Daniel Sanchez Anaya.
Viola Ray Ritchie.
Daria Daniela Taylor.
Hala Rippey.
Summer Temple.
Anissa Rivera.
Sophia Ann Tolentino.
Flor Sanchez Grajeda.
Cole Joseph Toro.
Emily Schultz.
Ruben Trejo Robles.
Devin Schumacher.
Victoria Grace Tunstall.
Hunter Siegel.
Leslie Valdez Portillo.
Michael Simsek.
Jacob Isaac Valentine.
Malia Skinner.
Gloria Valenzuela.
Giselle Abigail Soto Dominguez.
Lorenzo Emiliano Varela.
Derek Edward Stiernagel.
Faith Whitebro.
Lexi Talamantes Romero.
Jonah Wynn.
Reese Nicole Tavares.
Leandra Womack.
Adriana Velasquez.
Casey Woolhouse.
Dylan Victory.
Josie Yost.
Kenneth Vivanco.
Luis Armando Cepeda Hernandez.
Kaylee Wagner. Malachi Watson. Blake Weeks.
Ladies and gentlemen, family members, community members, parents, grandparents, nephews, nieces, everyone in the audience, it is my pleasure to be here in front of these inspiring young men and women who have, for the last 13 years, come together for this moment for a monumental achievement. This is a very big milestone of many milestones ahead for you. It's a pleasure for me to hear those inspiring speeches and see those big smiles on your faces today as you received your diploma. I just want you to remember the people that got you here. Your moms and dads, grandparents, your cousins, uncles, aunts, your teachers, and every school personnel that you came in contact with, teachers, principals, parapros, it's my pleasure to, right here. It's my pleasure to hereby certify you have met the requirements for graduation as set forth by the state and our governing board. I hereby confer upon each of you your high school diploma and welcome you to the company of scholars with all of its rights, honors, privileges, and obligations. Congratulations, you may now move your tassel from the right side to the left.
Thank you. Guys, great job. For those of you who don't know, when they came across the stage and were handing me things, they were all handing me combs. Love you guys. So graduates, if you will, please rise, and you will exit to the Prospector Circle one last time.
She wants to hold out. We're going to do it. We're going to do it.
Ladies and gentlemen, friends and family, and honored guests, I present to you the class of 2023 Apache Junction graduates. Congratulations, graduates! If you would, please wait for your graduates to get their diplomas and meet them as they depart the field. Thank you again, everybody. Great job, Apache Junction.
Now I'm jumping out of bed, yeah, and I know I sound dramatic, yeah, but I know I had to have it, yeah, for the money in my savage, yeah, I mean, it's like I had it, yeah, cause the runner told me back, yeah, but they didn't know me last year, yeah, everyone wanna act like they important, yeah, 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 but I don't need nothing when I saw my door. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Everyone counting on me, drop the bar. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Everything custom like I make a bar. Yeah, yeah. With wind, with your baddest sister. Outfit on my face, man, I got millions on my mind. Coming with a bullet, I just put it to the side. Bottle sets up ready, they can see it in my eye. My mama calls, see you on TV. Sunset don't change, ever since we was on, I dreamed it all. Ever since I was young, they said I won't be nothing. Now they always say congratulations. It's worth all my heart to vacation. They never had a dedication. People hating, trying to look we made it.
In the ball, baby. I'm looking for someone to call, baby. But right now I've got a situation. Never old being for you. Big ring, champagne. My life is like a ball game. But instead I'm in the trap, though. I'm gonna be call it Super Bowl. Super Bowl, caught up, in the world. Top throw lights out. I'm going Malone, I got a play on my phone. You know what I'm on. Hunter Houdini is gone.
My mama calls, see you on TV. Sunset done change. Ever since we was on, I dreamed it all. Ever since I was young, they said I won't be nothing. Now they always say congratulations. What's on my heart to vacation?
Oh, What way to keep my own thoughts?
I'm going to go to the next one. Thank you.